team, the 1990s, mean life without Chris Kinney. No doubt Coach Kathy Sanford misses the school's all-time scoring rebound against Steele's leader, but there may already be a new star in the making. Freshman Laura Seiden has some tough shoes to fill, but after the first 10 games this season, those shoes are starting to fit pretty well. Already, she's a three-time conference rookie of the week. This afternoon, it's the ECAC North Atlantic Conference opener for the Wildcats, and it's live on WMUR-TV. Live from Lundholm Gymnasium in Durham, WMUR Sports presents University of New Hampshire Basketball. This afternoon, it's a women's ECAC North Atlantic Conference matchup. The Huskies of Northeastern University visit the UNH Wildcats. Today's game is brought to you by McDonald's, where it's always a good time for the great taste. By Diet Coke, from the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Northern New England. By New Hampshire Sweets, the Granite States Lottery. By the Chevy Dealers of New England. Start where more people end up. And by Budweiser, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. Good afternoon and welcome to Lundholm Gymnasium for this afternoon's women's contest between the University of New Hampshire Wildcats and the Northeastern University Huskies. I'm Jeff Bacon along with Dave Olson. This is the first of 2 weeks in which we will showcase the women of the University of New Hampshire. The conference opener, Northeastern, has already played one conference game, losing to Maine. UNH 3-7, Northeastern 3-10, and Dave Olson, this is going to be a situation where you have two teams with totally conflicting styles of play.
You're absolutely right, Jeff. I think the key term today may be dictating tempo. If the game is played up-tempo at a fast pace, a lot of transition baskets, and it's played, you know, hard and a lot of running, it'll favor Northeastern. If UNH can get the Huskies into a half-court game, it's to their advantage.
You talk about the University of New Hampshire, you talk about a situation with the Chris Kinney being gone, she's playing ball in Europe, a big loss, but yet at the same time, Laura Seiden really has taken up a lot of the slack, more than expected, I think.
Laura Seiden has been a major impact player. In fact, on the UNH roster, you have six freshmen. Two are playing significant minutes, and Laura Seiden is among the leaders in eight categories for the UNH Wildcats. She had a terrific tournament then at the Holiday Classic in Central Florida, where she shot 59% from the floor, and she has been North Atlantic Conference Rookie of the Week three times already.
Not bad, considering they've only played for about 4 or 5 weeks. In fact, I think they've only given the award 3 weeks, or the three times she's been nominated, she has won it. As we take a look at Northeastern University, the only returning starter will be Charlene Blake. Darlene Strong is the point guard, and Charlene Blake, you get a look here, the only senior on the team.
Charlene Blake out of the Bronx, 5'7" senior, leads the team in scoring and steals.
Talitha Cox, a 6-foot junior, will be at center. This is Cordelia Washington. They changed the order around on this one. She's a 5'10". Freshman, and another young person, Michelle Brown, not young, a junior, but still an underclassman.
Young to you and I.
Now we can get a look at Talitha Cox. She's the person that they have to stop.
Talitha Cox is a junior college transfer out of Pittsburgh. She was at Mount Aloysius Junior College last year, a nationally ranked program. She's been an impact player thus far for the Huskies.
Some familiar faces if you follow New Hampshire high school basketball on this UNH team. Julie Donlin from Milton played her high school ball at Newt.
The UNH career three-point leader.
It's Shelly Fitz, also from New Hampshire, from Bow, went to Concord High.
Shelly Fitz, one of the tri-captains here at UNH.
Jeff Dorsch, the co-captain, a 5'10 senior. Well, Sue Ryan, also the forward. We need to look at her first from Methuen.
She's a 6-foot sophomore.
She leads the team in rebounds with five, and here's a look at Deb Dorsch.
Debbie Dorsch, 5'10 senior out of Bethpage, New York.
And the woman you've heard us speak highly of, Laura Seiden, just a freshman, 6'1", averaging just under 18 points a game. But that is even misleading, because when you look at her last few outings, she has had some impressive numbers. Against Fairfield the other day, she scored 26 points. The officials this afternoon, there are two of them. In men's competition, they have three, but women, we have two, Carol Bickford and Jack Reardon will call the shots on the floor this afternoon. It's the conference opener for the UNH Wildcats. We should mention a change in this conference situation, formerly known as the Seaboard Conference. They have disbanded that conference and formed the ECAC North Atlantic. The same teams from the women's universities match up with the men's universities, the same schools. The only difference from the Seaboard Conference, Central Connecticut is gone. That school was a member this year. Central Connecticut is now an independent team. So we got ready to kick off action again. UNH 3-7, coming off a tough loss against Fairfield the other night. Both teams, in terms of common opponents, Dave, Holy Cross, BC, Fairfield, both teams lost to all three, but UNH played all three a lot closer. So if you look at it on paper, UNH should be the favorite.
Should be, but games aren't played on paper, and here we go.
Jumping for Northeastern, Cox, it'll be Seiden for UNH, and Cox controls it for Northeastern. It is Cordelia Washington who initially gets it out to Darlene Strong, the point guard. And again, keep an eye on Cox on the post as UNH will be coming out in a zone. Just underway here at Lundholm Gymnasium, UNH and Northeastern in a women's ECAC North Atlantic Conference game. And the first shot of the game by Cox is good. The 6-foot junior who leads a team with 9 block shots on the defensive end. It does it offensively there. A quick 2-0 lead for Northeastern. There's a look at Seiden, her first shot. She has Seiden
was free along the baseline and simply got the entry pass turned and had a clear path to the hole.
UNH showing some pressure early on.
Zone pressure here, 1-2-2.
It is Darlene Strong. Now it's Charlene Blake. Blake, the quickest member of this Northeastern team, feeds it underneath, the shot missed by Brown, but the rebound and the follow by Cox, and she's got the first 4 points of the game for Northeastern, a 4-2 Husky lead.
Michelle Brown got good position on the weak side that time. Nobody checked her, and she was able to go up strong to the hoop with a rebound.
Shelly Fitz with the ball, gets it left side. Donlin, the 3-point sharpshooter, not on the mark this time, but the rebound is up and missed by Sue Ryan. Deb Dorsch gets it back, a 3rd try, this time it's ball.
Debbie Dorsch working hard on the offensive glass. She was the Cats' number 2 rebounder a year ago.
In fact, Dorsch was a number 2 scorer as well in the shadow of Chris Kinney. A bad pass, and Donovan wisely lets it go out of bounds. The Wildcats will take it back in a 4-4 game.
Cats working hard on that extended zone pressure, causing the Huskies to turn it over there, and they'll take over. Northeastern playing pretty much straight man-to-man.
It's a 30-second shot clock in women's basketball as well. In the men's, they have 45-second clock. Seiden from the foul line. Dorsch again tears the rebound down, but there's a blocked shot for Cox, who now has 10 this season. Northeastern with the ball. It's Blake. And she's fouled by Fitz. The shot counts. Blake will go to the line.
That'll be a matchup we'll be watching all afternoon. Shelly Fitz and Charlene Blake. Blake, the leading scorer for the Huskies at 10.4 a game. And Shelly Fitz, who usually draws the tough defensive assignments for the Cats. We see it here. Let's watch Blake. Right there, number 11. Fakes Fitz, draws the contact, senses the impending call, and puts it up for 2. Make it 3 as she converts.
Northeastern by 3 with 17:56 to go, just underway in the first half. It's Seiden on the pass from Dorsch, and Seiden's shot is blocked.
Huskies on the run. This is what UNH wants to stay away from.
And the Wildcats managed to get back in time to force a bad pass, and UNH will take it back over again, 7-4 Northeastern. Julie Donlin, the point guard. She likes to fire that 3-pointer. She holds all 3-point records here at UNH. Dorsch inside, shot blocked. Ryan with the shot, and she's fouled.
Perhaps we can take a look at that again when we get a chance. That was a nice pass by Deb Dorsch, number 20. Sue Ryan, 6-foot sophomore from Methuen, Mass.
That foul was called on Hillary Harwell, who came in off the bench.
Ryan yell off there as soon as she released it. She knew.
And Harwell gets the rebound for Northeastern. It's Strong. Blake now has it, I should say. Number 11, Blake. Harwell misses. Gets her own rebound, and nice shot by Hillary Harwell. Reverse. Didn't even use the backboard.
Well, that was an acrobatic move right there by Hillary Harwell. So far, UNH is getting beaten up on the offensive glass.
And they were more concerned about getting beaten up with the speed factor. Seiden from outside. Bangs one in.
Great blind pass there by Shelly Fitz. not looking at Seiden, but got the ball to her, and she was open for the J.
And a save by Fitz. It's bounced off of Dorsch right to Seiden. And UNH will set it up. Dave, that's one thing I was going to ask you about with putting this pressure on down on the northeastern end, I should say on the UNH end. Seiden blocked from behind. He's fouled. But I wonder if that isn't going to hurt them because they're not as fast and would they not be able to get back in time?
What they're trying to, I think Coach Sanborn is trying to do there is to keep Northeastern from getting out on the break and running and disrupting their offense. It also forces the ball handlers on Northeastern to make accurate reads of what the defense is doing, which if you don't make the accurate read is going to cause a turnover more often than not.
Laura Seiden with 5 points already. 5 of the 7 UNH points. It's a 2-point game now. Cats trail by 2. Making one. So far, Seiden is everything we expected.
Here's that extended pressure again by the Cats.
And Northeastern breaks it easily. Charlene Blake.
UNH now in a 3-2 zone. See, they're matching up off. This is a 3-2 match as Ryan is matching up on number 32, Cox.
And a travel violation against the Huskies will give UNH the ball and a chance to take the lead with 16:15 to go in the first half.
And we use the term matchup zone. It means that one or more of the five players on the floor defensively are in a man posture. The balance of the players are still playing an area or a zone.
Fitz misses off the mark and foul called underneath. That's against Seiden. Karen McCoy, number 31, the first one off the bench, is now into the game, and she, most of the time, will spell Sue Ryan, who occasionally gets into some foul trouble.
McCoy is one of those freshmen we spoke about, 5'10" from Westwood, Massachusetts.
Boston Globe All-Scholastic player, second team. Donlin with the steal at Dorsch, and Dorsch is fouled.
Nice lead by Donlin. Perhaps we can take a look at that again. We said UNH would like to dictate tempo here, but Coach Sanborn told us if they get a chance to push it in transition off the steal, they will. But you watch it here again. You see Julie Donlin from Newt High School in Milton, New Hampshire, coming down.
Well, Dorsch
pass there to Dorsch.
And Dorsch, the best free throw shooter on the team. Donlin was the one who fed it to Dorsch. Dorsch from the line, 84.2, as you see on the graphic there. Tremendous free throw shooter. That's a great percentage. He puts them both in to give UNH their first lead of the game at 10-9.
Huskies handle the pressure that time.
Darlene Strong doing the dribbling, gets it to Blake.
UNH back in that matchup zone, 3-2.
Russell Daly Washington back out on top. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Knocked out of bounds by McCoy. And with 7 seconds on the shot clock, the Huskies will maintain control.
See McCoy there fronting Cox and getting a hand on that ball.
Inside, it's good. Count it. Cordelia Washington, a freshman, averaging just under 7 points a game, hits and she's fouled.
That was a very tough shot by Cordelia Washington. Perhaps we can take a look at that again. You'll see Cordelia here cutting into the lane. Good defensive pressure, but she goes up between three Wildcats and draws nothing but net and draws a foul.
Shelly Fitz committing that foul. It'll be one shot. And it's the second three-point play of the afternoon for Northeastern.
Cordelia, a freshman of Newark, New Jersey.
12-10, Northeastern, shot blocked there, or I should say the pass by Cox, and here come the Huskies. Blake almost traveled.
Huskies couldn't finish off that 3-on-1.
Now it's a 3-on-2 for the Cats. Dorsch, rebound Northeastern, goes to Strong.
This is not the pace that UNH wants to play this game at.
And you see why, as Cordelia Washington finishes it off. And Northeastern now leads by 4.
Huskies want to play it at a frantic pace.
Washington with 5 points now. Fitz wants it. It's not a three. And McCoy comes up with a rebound. We'll talk about her rebounding prowess in a minute. She has 4.8 rebounds a game, and she's not in there very much when you put it in relativity to the rest of the starters.
The ratio to minutes played.
That's what I'm trying to say.
There you go. You're all right, Jeff. The offense at UNH is running now is something we'll get into in a little bit. We have to take a break.
All right, UNH trails by four, but don't go away.
Woo! You know you're gonna shout, buy a Chevy and shout, get a great deal and shout, buy a Chevy and shout, come on, y'all, Chevrolet.
Chevy trucks are really worth shouting about. Not only do they come with Instatrack 4x4 so you can shift on the fly, now they come with up to $1,250 cash back. And that's not too tough to take.
Buy a Chevy and shout!
This voyage is for Pepsi drinkers everywhere. There's a whole nother world out there. Diet Coke. Discover the one-calorie real cola taste worth leaving Pepsi for.
The taste of it.
One giant sip for mankind.
Hi, come on in. You know, if you've been injured or suffered a loss, the law may provide you with a right to compensation. Unfortunately, your rights don't just happen. You often have to fight for them.
I'm attorney Vincent Martina. Call me for a free consultation about your rights and how to win them. If I work for you, I'll fight for you.
Don't forget, every weekend on WMUR, you can get the lowdown on all the picks for the major college basketball games on Billy Packer's College Basketball Preview. Get the inside info on your favorite teams every Saturday afternoon at 12:30 right here on WMUR TV.
I like that. There you go. Notice out of this timeout now, the Cats have pulled the pressure back. They're not extended like they were initially.
It's a 14-10 game. Northeastern with the lead in the ball. The bounce pass goes off the ankle of Khalifa Cox. It's recovered by Blake, and Cox underneath. Nice feed from Charlene Blake to Khalifa Cox.
Notice in that set, the Huskies were looking to go down low continually for Cox.
And they do that all the time. In fact, if you look at their three-point shooting, they've taken 13 attempts all season long. Julie Donlan will take that many in a game if she has the shot. She's so good from that three-point line. Deb Dorsch, we're going to give her two.
Good-looking stroke there by Deb Dorsch. Here's that pressure again.
Dorsch now with 6 points, and it's a four-point game, Northeastern on top.
Cats back in at 3-2.
There's Cox underneath again. This time it won't fall, but Cox had the job, did the job posting up. Seiden Cox, a little bit of mismatch there. Seiden, not a bad defensive player, but going against Cox, she's tough.
I guess Cox is tough. She's a great player on the block from what we've seen.
Speaking of blocks, that was McCoy with the block, and Northeastern got a back shot no good underneath by Washington, and it's UNH's ball. Julie Donlin taking it up for the Wildcats.
UNH could have possibly pushed that up, but you notice they want to slow it down. They want to run this offense, which I started to talk about before the break. This is known as a flex offense. There's a lot of screens away from the ball, a lot of picks down low, and basically you're trying to free people by using screens and picks.
3 points for Julie Donlin.
And that is Julie Donlin, specially the three-bagger.
She holds the UNH record with 6 in a game. Foul called on Karen McCoy.
We were talking about Karen McCoy before, Jeff, and her ratio of rebounds to minutes played. She has, going into today's game, 48 rebounds in 135 minutes, which ties her for second place on the team. Seiden has 48 in 326 minutes, and the leader is Ryan with 50 in 214 minutes. So you can see what kind of ratio of rebounds to minutes played that McCoy has.
Strong missed that shot from downtown. The ball tied up, jump ball called. Alternating possession goes to the University of New Hampshire, trailing by one. 12:39 to go in the first half.
Opening North Atlantic Conference game of the year for the Wildcats.
Seiden wants it again. This time, no good. Rebound Cox, who crashed the boards for that one. Jen Casey, number 33, into the game for UNH. And underneath with a nice move, but hit Darlene Strong. Ball's out of bounds. UNH has the ball.
Great move by Darlene Strong. She just couldn't finish it off.
Julie Donlin, who leads the team in the conference with 56 assists. It's Casey from behind. McCoy hammers Blake. That's her second foul. Neither team in the bonus yet.
I'll tell you, Cox is a tough player in that particular set. Laura Seiden of UNH was trying to get low and post up, but Cox wouldn't let it happen. She got real physical down low.
A couple of changes. Jessica Arnold, number 31, comes in for Northeastern. You see in the middle of your screen there, 44, Deb Russell right there. Deb from Kennett High School, a freshman, has really come around, coming from a Class I state championship program. It's a small school, though, to playing Division I basketball, and Kathy Stanborn's pretty impressed with what she's shown so far this season.
Deb Russell is a dominant player up at Kennett.
Strong with a pretty shot, but give her two. Taking those shots just shy of the three-point line. Signed with a deflection. Foul called. It would have counted if it went in.
Couldn't get the roll.
Yeah, I wonder with Northeastern, they're hitting from just shy of the three-point line. Is it that big of a difference to step back 3 inches and fire it up?
I don't know. For me, it would be. Laura Seiden out of Rivervale, New Jersey, steps to the line. She'll have a couple.
Seiden now with 7 points in an 18-16 game as you get a look at the Wildcat bench, and a good bench.
We said Laura Seiden, the offensive leader in 8 separate categories, and this her freshman year. She has been a major impact player from the get-go.
Charlene Blake, 5'7 senior, calling the shots for Northeastern. Now Arnold has it. UNH still in that zone.
Cats moving well in this set defensively.
Washington inside off the front. Scooped up by Dorsch, and she's being hounded by Blake. She gets it off to Donlin, and here come the Cats.
Casey had a notion out there.
It's Russell now with 15 seconds to go on the shot clock. If you joined us late, it's a 30-second shot clock in women's collegiate hoop. Side and way off. Russell's there. Count it. Deb Russell.
What a great rebound by Russell. Maybe we can take a look at that one again when we get a chance. Deb Russell. See the shot by Seiden is up and off. Watch Debbie Russell. Goes in, back up, off glass, and is fouled. She'll have a chance for the three-point play.
Fouled by Jessica Arnold. And Russell completes a three-point play. UNH in front now by two. 10:43 to go in the first half. Chess match here at Lundholm Gymnasium. An up-tempo team against a half-court team, and so far the half-court team's out in front by a bucket.
Cats once again looking very alert on defense.
And Russell just rips down the rebound, but she's tied up. UNH doesn't like the call. Kathy Sandborn cheering on her team from the bench. She liked where Russell showed some aggressiveness there, and in the alternating possession rule this time, I think it's going to be Northeastern's ball. Should be. And the Huskies want a timeout with 10:26 to go.
Might have been a bit of a quick whistle there, but we'll be back with more basketball action right after this.
When he heard the news, he left in haste. Didn't want to miss that big, bold taste.
McDonald's Caramels.
It's beef from McDonald's, a quarter pound on a toasted rye bun, but it won't stay around.
McDonald's Caramels.
With cheddar cheese sauce, grilled onions too. It's a big, bold taste, too good to be true.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
Cheddar Melt.
For a limited time.
To go.
At McDonald's.
Unfortunately, you can't always pick your fellow traveler.
Hi, 22E. My name's Nadine. I'm a Pisces.
Have our paths crossed before?
Yes, they have, the Miss Bayou Bell hair pageant. I was first runner-up.
But you can pick a winner. Pick three, pick four. New Hampshire's Daily Numbers Game. The luck starts here.
Fish cakes are my favorites. You want your taters?
Michelob Dry introduces the 20-ounce dry. The one dry for two. rainy nights aren't much fun. Except when it's pouring inside. Shouldn't your night belong to Michelob Light?
The Night Court last continue on WMUR-TV. Now on Saturdays at 7:30. Tonight, Dan is taken hostage in a sleazy hotel by a psychotic female prisoner. Can't wait. The last are on Night Court tonight at 7:30 on WMUR-TV. Gotta love that Dan, huh?
Oh, yeah. He's quite a guy.
Just describe what's going to happen to me. He starts cracking up. UNH with the lead, Northeastern with the ball. Nice pass inside by Strong. But again, it doesn't fall. Arnold with the rebound doesn't get it. And he went traveling there. Washington missed the shot on the initial entry pass, and it was a pretty pass. And then Arnold decided to go for a walk.
Cross court right over the top of that zone.
That was Blake with the pass, not Strong. Blake number 11, Strong number 12. Deb Doris to Deb Russell. Keeping it around the perimeter, not much action underneath, but Russell tries to sneak under as Donlin takes it out deep. Now Russell from downtown. Seiden tried to get it from over the head, and Russell with a good pass. Deb Russell impressing early on.
She's showing us the form, the kind of form she exhibited in high school at Kennett, where she scored over 1,800 points and had over 1,000 rebounds in her high school career.
5 points for Deb Russell. Strong up top to Washington. Back to Strong. Russell easily outsides and Strong. All the other side is Blake. Air ball. Blake goes down. No foul called. Arnold fights for it underneath. Misses. Gets it back. I'll tell you, if Arnold could hit from under there, Northeastern might have the lead. She's been doing the job on the offensive glass, but she can't get it to fall.
She's really gotten up on the offensive glass, especially in the last two sets. Very strong rebounder.
Donlin takes it deep. Gets it to Casey. Casey has to take it back out. The junior from Deerfield, Illinois, gets it unintended for a side. Good idea, but not a good pass.
So far here, with 8:51 to go in half number one, we've seen a pattern by UNH defensively. After a field goal by Northeastern, they fall into some sort of a zone, usually a 3-2 match, where the middle player, either McCoy or Ryan, is fronting Cox. Off the miss shot, they're trying to pick the Huskies up a man, because they don't want them to get out and run.
You can get a good look from up top in our camera up top at this zone that UNH is running right now as well. He's taking the middle, number 20, Doris. She's just moving around, trying to keep whoever's trying to post up on her. And the shot from the foul line is missed by Washington. It's out of bounds off of Northeastern. It went off of Hillary Harwell, and UNH will get it back with a four-point lead, 8:28 to go in the first half.
A little token man pressure here by the Huskies. Charlene Blake. On Donlin.
Jen Casey. Donlin wide open on baseline. What a move by Donlin as she started getting some defensive pressure. Yeah. UNH still manages to keep it. Doris wants it. And Seiden had two on her, so I should say Russell two covering her, so Northeastern gets it. Russell did a good job boxing out. When you got two people on you, it's kind of hard to pull it down.
Absolutely.
Washington on the top. Now to the side. It's Charlene Blake. Blake hits. 5 points for Charlene Blake. No foul call from behind. Donlin lost it. Blake almost got the credit for a steal.
That's fortunate there.
Siding up top. Russell will take that. She's already shown it a couple of times. It's out to Casey. She's got the shot. With 4 seconds to go on the shot clock. Rolls around, Northeastern gets it.
Cats back quickly to take that break possibility away from the Huskies.
Harwell credited with the rebound on that play. Strong, no good, but comes right back out. A Northeastern bounce to Washington. A couple of substitutions coming our way for UNH at the next stoppage in play. 22-20, UNH by two, and now we're tied up. Charlene Blake goes baseline.
What a good-looking offensive player Charlene Blake is. Pumping there and putting it up for two.
Well, they haven't put it up on the scoreboard, but it is a tie game unless there's been a mistake in the scoreboard from before and they decided to keep it that way. We'll have to check on that. Now they change it. We are tied at 22. It's official. Dorsch, just shy of the three, comes right back to the floor, draws the foul. Hillary Harwell called for the foul, and she kind of chuckles.
Hillary thought she had position there. Nice follow of the miss by Deb Dorsch. Perhaps we can take a look at that again.
I don't know if we'll have time. We just well, this is shooting foul here. We might have time. No, now it's not a shooting foul. I thought she was shooting. She really did. Allison Gagnon, a freshman, number 15, into the game for her first time. She's in for Julie Donlin. From behind, another steal by Blake out of bounds, but UNH will keep it.
Blake is very active defensively, as well as being a fine offensive player. In fact, a year ago against Pittsburgh, a Big East school, she had 9 steals in a game.
It's a dangerous move, reaching in like that, but so far she's done it cleanly. Seiden.
Pretty good stroke for a freshman.
10 points already for Seiden, and we've still got just under 6 minutes to go in the first half.
Now you talk about that reach and being a dangerous move, Jeff, it is, but there are certain people who just have the knack of being successful. One of those that comes to mind is Dennis Johnson of the Celtics.
Gagging with a bad pass. Stolen away by Northeastern. Strong. Perimeter shooting is a little bit off, Dave. I guess they rely more on some of their bench players to come up with the outside shooting while they try to work it inside with the starting five. And this time, Seiden comes up with the steal. Gagnon has to dribble away from traffic.
And this particular unit's on the floor. They look for Cox a lot down low. That's the first option they run when they're in a half-court set.
Seiden has the lane. Block, foul called in, and I thought committing it all ball. Actually, Cox got all ball, but from the other end, they're calling the foul on Michelle Brown, number 24.
That's a great move there by Laura Seiden, driving the lane. You'll see it here. Watch. Defender gets a hand on the ball. She still has the presence and the strength to get the shot off. That's why she's going to line.
Rivervale, New Jersey, the hometown of Laura Seiden, a heavily recruited came down to UNH and Yale, and she decided to take UNH, an honor student here, by the way, we should add, a very intelligent student.
Unofficial, I have her for 11 points.
Well, that's what our statistician, Sid Slark, has on the other side of you as well. The three-point game, UNH on top. The shot is good by Charlene Blake. Leads the team with 50 steals, 35 assists, and 10.5 points a game. So she does it all for the Huskies. Gagnon wants a pair. Give it to her.
So important when you're bringing that ball up and playing the point to have that outside shot so the defense respects that and they can't sag in the middle.
You should emphasize that Gagnon is a walk-on as well. Kick called against Fitz. They're going to restart the shot clock. And we're gonna restart our engines. We'll take a break. We'll be back with 4:21 to go. UNH on top.
The Cadillac DeVille, please.
In weather like this, you'll be happy to know the Cadillac DeVille has front-wheel drive because that gives you better traction in the snow.
My town car, please.
On the other hand, Lincoln Town Car has never had front-wheel drive, and that could leave you out in the cold. With front-wheel drive and V8 power, you'll enjoy Cadillac style in any weather. So now's the perfect time to test drive a new DeVille at your Cadillac Trendsetter dealer.
The traffic makes me crazy. By the time I get to Boston, I'm a wreck.
So it's 10:15. I'm supposed to be at my meeting on State Street, and I'm lost in Chinatown.
We finally find a parking garage, and they want $8 to park for 1 hour in downtown Boston.
Why would anyone drive when there's a better way to Boston? Concord Trailways has fast, frequent service to Boston from Concord, Manchester, and Londonderry. All day long, every day. Concord Trailways. Why would anyone drive?
Yeah.
Safari by Skidoo. More fun than your wildest dreams. Join the Safari Adventure and get the Safari Safeguard Guarantee. Get the details at your nearest participating Skidoo dealer.
Our live broadcast of UNH basketball will continue next Saturday at 1 as the UNH women take on Vermont. Join us 1 week from today with all the live action, 1 o'clock, right here on WMUR-TV. And I guess that's one where I might not be as objective, huh, Dave?
I was going to say, Jeff, the key question concerning that game in the minds of everyone is who will you be rooting for?
I'm objective, even though I did go to Vermont, right? Shot missed by Harwell. Rebound put up by missed again. Foul called. Well, actually, I'm looking forward to it, Dave, because you got UVM coming in twice, and UNH-UVM, always a good rivalry. Hockey, basketball, whatever the sport may be, and we'll have a men's contest coming up on the 18th as well.
18th of February.
You got it. It's a Sunday, a special Sunday telecast, but right now we're talking UNH Northeastern women, a conference opener here underneath doors from Gagnon. They take it back out, down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. New Hampshire leading by three. And Dorsch loses it. The steal credited to Harwell, and they still haven't. Finally, Dorsch takes it. Foul call. Harwell wanted travel.
UNH not looking very sharp on that particular offensive set because there wasn't enough movement away from the basketball.
And Harwell, number 23 for Northeastern, was pretty adamant as she takes a seat now back into the game. Cordelia Washington. Rather rapid substituting by Joy Marchioti, the ninth season at Northeastern.
I would say over the past 20 years, Northeastern has had one of the more successful women's programs in New England.
But at the same time, really, and I'm not just saying this, you have to give New Hampshire credit. They've been up there year after year as well.
Oh, look, the Cats have been very competitive.
And Strong with a shot from downtown. Cuts the point, the lead to one for New Hampshire with 3:20 to go. Coming up at halftime, we'll interview a couple of alumni that are in town. And Seiden goes in and out. Rebound Russell. This time it won't fall. No foul called. Rebound Blake.
Good look to the weak side that time by the Cats and a nice offensive rebound by Deb Russell. Just couldn't get it to go down, though.
Finish up what I was talking about halftime. The alumni women had their annual game before the tip-off of this one. Rebound by Dorsch on the shot by Washington. And we'll talk with a couple of former Wildcat stars coming up at halftime. Along with our, as always, crack stats from Sid Slark and a couple of highlights as well. So don't go away at halftime. Steal by Blake. And she's going to go all the way in. No good. Charlene Blake.
Nobody back to help Fitz.
Steal.
Cats fortunate there as everybody else was up court. Gagnon was covered.
Deb Dorsch, a tri-captain, along with Shelly Fitz and Rita McCarroll. Fitz, I should say, Dorsch in all kinds of trouble. Seiden's bounce pass slapped away, and it's recovered by Northeastern.
Making that entry pass down on the block like that takes terrific timing, and that time, UNH was not set up on the low post. And the pass was batted away and stolen by the Huskies.
Michelle Brown credited with that steal for Northeastern. With 1:44 to go, shot by Strong is good.
High five sophomore. Looks like she has a pretty good outside stroke.
And Northeastern goes back in front by one with a minute and a half to go in the first half. Seiden takes the cross-court pass from Dorsch and scores. Dorsch Seiden with 13 points.
Last couple times down the floor for the Cats, they've been able to find Seiden on that weak side who's been open on that baseline.
Northeastern finished second in the Seaboard Conference tournament last year despite finishing fourth in the regular season, while UNH finished second in the regular season. Shot no good by Washington. Rebound Cox. She overthrows, and Deb Russell hauls it down.
Nice position by Deb Russell once again.
We're under a minute to play in the first half. New Hampshire by one. Deb Dorsch runs into Fitz. Dorsch for three. and Russell was boxed out. She still almost got that rebound. Michelle Brown did a good job boxing out for Northeastern, and Cordelia Washington wanted to run towards the hoop before she got the ball, and it's going to be UNH's ball.
Got to have the ball before you can take it to the hole, and how many times have you done that if you've ever played this game?
Sue Ryan back in for the Cats. Allison Gagnon and Fitz the guards. Laura Seiden, who's been in the whole first half at center. Dorshan Ryan at the forwards. Seiden comes back out, almost traveled, gets it to Dorsh, tailed by Washington. Fitz for two, no good. Brown with a rebound, and we've got 11 seconds as you see the clock ticking away in the first half. It's a one-point game, New Hampshire up. Northeastern can take the lead. Gagnon did the job defensively to keep Northeastern from taking the lead before halftime.
Great hustle by Allison Gagnon, and that'll do it for half number one. Cats by one.
We'll be back.
When he heard the news, he left in haste. Didn't want to miss that big, bold taste.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
It's beef from McDonald's, a quarter pound on a toasted rye bun, but it won't stay around.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
With cheddar cheese sauce, grilled onions too, it's a big, bold taste, too good to be true.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
Cheddar Melt.
For a limited time.
To go.
At McDonald's.
Is brewed longer. One Dry is brewed from the most expensive ingredients. One Dry refreshes completely. One taste, and you'll know why. The One Dry is Michelob Dry.
The government will spend nearly $300 billion on defense. Meanwhile, your local Volvo dealer can help protect you and your family for considerably less.
See your local New England dealer to buy or lease a new Volvo today.
Do I have to spell it out for you? I'm leaving. L-E-A-V-I-N-G. Leaving. I'm just not satisfied anymore. For years it was sweet with a capital S, but now I'm changing more than my clothes. I've discovered something that fits my style.
Discover the one-calorie real cola taste worth leaving Pepsi for.
Just for the taste of it.
Sorry, Pepsi. I'm taking this for a spin.
Diet Coke.
Welcome back live to Lundholm Gymnasium, where the UNH Wildcats lead Northeastern at halftime 29-28. Today's a special day as well. It's Alumni Day for the UNH basketball women. They were back really doing a pretty good job on the court going back and forth. We'll show you some highlights of that game as well. And we've got Kelly Butterfield and Denise Higgins, both played in the early to mid-80s. First, Kelly, you graduated in 1984, was it? 84 for Denise. First, we'll start with you, Kelly. Block shot, rebound, scoring and rebounding, fourth all time. Just talk about coming back and the fact that you do this every year.
Well, this is my first year actually coming back for an alumni game. I've been away a little bit. I've been playing overseas. Lucky enough to do that. It's fantastic this year coming back, seeing everyone. You know, I haven't gotten in contact with too many of the women. And it's fantastic having this going on back, playing against them. A little out of breath today. I'll tell you, I'm out of shape, but it was great to have this opportunity.
Talk about your experience playing overseas. Chris Kinney, of course, we're following her. She's over in Europe now. It's not an easy adjustment, is it?
No, it's not. I was lucky enough that I went over to a country that was English-speaking. My first two seasons were in Ireland. My second two were in Australia. But I loved it. You know, I loved being over in another country, living there, learning different cultures, and being able to, you know, getting paid to play basketball. The most important thing to me was to play basketball. It was my job.
I was watching the game early, and it seemed to be pretty competitive.
Here on the court today? Oh, yeah, you don't lose that. I mean, you always want to win.
Okay, Kelly, well, welcome back, and thanks for joining us. Good to see you. Now we've got Denise Higgins. She is the block shot queen. She leads in the season block shots, career block shots as well. How many did you have this afternoon?
I think only two.
You weren't keeping track, though. You never lose that, right?
No.
What about for you coming back? What have you been doing since you graduated in 1984?
Well, I coached basketball for a couple of years at a high school level, and I'm playing on the amateur league right now.
When you come back and you see all your old teammates and some that you didn't play with, some that have been before you, you look at the team now, do you see any changes? Do you see a change in the game at all? A little more up-tempo now than it was back then by chance?
It's a little bit quicker, I think, with the smaller ball. When we played, we had the larger ball, and they switched to the smaller ball, and it seems that really, you know, the game is much faster than it was when we played.
Well, you play with a smaller ball today. Is it easier to shoot for you?
It's a lot easier to rebound, I think, because you can really hang on to it. You know, it's fit for your hands now, you know, so you can do a lot more with a lot more control than, you know, we had.
Women's athletics in general, the UNH basketball team always seems to be right up there. What is it? Is it a, why is it? What is it about, you know, getting such a good program year after year?
I just think they have a good spirit, you know. I mean, everyone is like a clique, you know. You're out here, you're playing tough together, and, you know, it's just everyone's friends, you know.
Hey, Denise, thanks a lot. Welcome back, and enjoy the rest of the game. We are at halftime at Lundholm Gym. UNH leading Northeastern 29-28. Again, a reminder, it's an ECAC North Atlantic Conference opener. They've switched conferences now. Seaboard Conference is out. ECAC North Atlantic Conference is in. Northeastern 0-1 after losing to Maine. We've got stats coming up, some highlights as well, so don't go away. We'll be back.
Chocolate. Cream. Custard. Cake, the flavor of Boston Cream Pie in a limited edition Deering ice cream. Boston Cream Pie ice cream, something really special from Deering ice cream.
Watching your weight but craving a sweet, try Deering's Calorie Counter. Worried about cholesterol? Eat Deering's Calorie Counter. It's as smooth as fine ice cream with only 70 calories per serving and completely cholesterol free. Enjoy.
Auto Love's Lincoln Mercury of Exeter Stratum is now having a low monthly payment blowout sale. $99 a month buys any used vehicle in stock, like an 88 Chevy C15 4x4, $99 a month. Or an 85 Ford Bronco with plow, $99 a month. Or an 86 Chevy 4x4 pickup with cab, $99 a month. Hurry over to the home of the low monthly payments. Auto Love's Lincoln Mercury of Exeter Stratum, next to Ames Plaza, Route 101, Exeter.
When you put four individuals together, there's no guarantee that they'll work in harmony. So when we merged our four banks, we made sure they did. As Dartmouth Bank will offer everything you expect from a great bank, and some things you might not expect.
Angina, the medical term for heart pain, and a word that can truly strike fear in your heart. But how can you tell if you've suffered angina? Ask yourself, where is the pain? What does it feel like? Does the pain seem to move? Have your answers ready, then call your doctor. The New Hampshire Heart Institute believes the more you know about heart disease, the better prepared you'll be to prevent it.
Today's halftime report was brought to you by Divine Millamet Stahl & Branch, serving as legal counsel for the University of New Hampshire for over 30 years.
Welcome back to Lundholm Gymnasium. Jeff Bacon and Dave Olson for the first of our two live broadcasts of the UNH women. So far, so good. 29-28, a close game. We expected a close game, but again, as you mentioned on the outset, on paper, it looks to be UNH's game. But then as Dave quickly corrected me, the game isn't played on paper. Your initial thoughts at halftime so far, everything you expected, Dave?
I think so. I think Northeastern has been a little sloppier with the basketball in terms of handling it when they have had the chance to break. What Northeastern has done very well is get up on the offensive glass and create some second and third shots. UNH, initially their pressure, their extended defensive pressure and a zone posture bothered the Huskies a little bit at the beginning. They've gotten a very good first half from Laura's side. Hey, they've gotten a very good freshman year from Laura's side thus far. And Charlene Blake did a good job at the other end for Northeastern.
Well, those are the two leading scorers. Seiden, no surprise. Let's take a look at one of her baskets early on in the first half. She scored 13 points, 5 of 6 from the free throw line. And Seiden just seems to be doing it all.
See you there. Number 20 with the ball is Deb Dorsch, going to the weak side to the freshman, Laura Seiden. Puts the ball on the deck, fakes, leans in under the defensive pressure, and goes up with the little kiss.
And it was a nice move to beat Talitha Cox as well, who was expected to really give Sidon some trouble. Meanwhile, in the up-tempo game of Northeastern, you've got Charlene Blake and Darlene Strong, the guards. Blake right now doing the scoring, leading with 9, and she's not afraid to take the ball in the paint, but she stuck a couple from outside. We didn't necessarily expect to see that.
Strong looked a pretty good outside shooter, but Charlene Blake, we saw some terrific athleticism out of her in this first half. As you said, she had 9 points. She came into today's game averaging almost 10.5 points a game, and very good defensive player as well.
We do have a highlight of her somewhere. I'll take a look at it. There we go. Blake is number 11.
See the pass over to her. Starts to move to the hoop. Goes up against the defensive pressure between two UNH defenders. Uses the glass nicely to get the field goal.
And that's where they need to get their points, because we mentioned earlier, they've only taken 13 three-point shots all season long. They've hit on just 4 of them. They just don't have a three-point shooter, so they haven't been able to take advantage of that particular rule. But on the other hand, you've got Julie Donlin, who can fire it up from three-point land, but again, they haven't needed it right now.
No, they haven't needed it right now. They've been able to run that flex offense in the half-court set pretty effectively. It broke down a little bit towards the end of the first half, but they've been getting the screens and the picks down low and away from the ball and been able to free some shooters up. So it should be an interesting second half.
As we get a look at Jerry Friel, the former UNH men's basketball coach, talking to Denise Higgins and Kelly Butterfield, our two halftime guests, and he gives us a chance to talk about Jerry's job. I was here Wednesday night for the Bring Back the Bruins Night UNH hockey, and the University of New Hampshire really is making one whale of an effort to try to establish more interest in the entire state. I know they've been concerned that sometimes university might be perceived as more of a seacoast institution, but for the first time, they've got Jerry Friel doing all this work, and I think it'll pay dividends in the end. But we'll be back right now. UNH leading Northeastern 29-28. We're at halftime. We've got more stats to pass along to you. We come back. Stay with us.
Today's halftime report is brought to you by Divine Millamette Stahl and Branch Professional Association, providing over 30 years of legal counsel for the University of New Hampshire.
When he heard the news, he left in haste. Didn't want to miss that big, bold taste.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
It's beef from McDonald's, a quarter pound, on a toasted rye bun, but it won't stay around.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
With cheddar cheese sauce, grilled onions too, it's a big, bold taste, too good to be true.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
Cheddar Melt.
For a limited time. To go at McDonald's.
The traffic makes me crazy. By the time I get to Boston, I'm a wreck.
So it's 10:15. I'm supposed to be at my meeting on State Street, and I'm lost in Chinatown.
We finally find a parking garage, and they want $8 to park for 1 hour in downtown Boston.
Why would anyone drive when there's a better way to Boston? Concord Trailways has fast, frequent service to Boston from Concord, Manchester, and Londonderry. All day long, every day. Concord Trailways. Why would anyone drive?
Life is full of surprises. Some are good and some not so good. And when the not so good surprise is a vehicle collision, it's reassuring to know that the professionals at Frank Yanko's Auto Body are highly skilled technicians that repair all makes and models. And remember, it's your choice where to go for your auto body repair. So in a crunch,
oh no!
Come to Frank Yanko's Auto Body for lasting quality. Your vehicle will be worth it down the road.
You know you're gonna shop, buy a Chevy and get a great deal and shop, buy a Chevy and come on y'all, Chevrolet,
Chevrolet,
Chevrolet.
Hey, these tough Chevy trucks are really worth shouting about. Not only do they come with Instatrack 4x4 so you can shift on the fly, now they come with up to $1,250 cash back. And that's not too tough to take.
Buy a Chevy and shop!
Today's game is brought to you by McDonald's, where it's always a good time for the great taste. By Diet Coke, from the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Northern New England. By New Hampshire Sweeps, the Granite States Lottery. By the Chevy Dealers of New England, start where more people end up. And by Budweiser, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. We're still at halftime with Northeastern trailing the University of New Hampshire 29-28. And it's been a very fast-paced game, Dave Olson. It's gone by quickly. And I think that if you ask New Hampshire, they didn't necessarily want that fast-paced game.
Well, as we said at the outset, they want to control the tempo. They prefer the half-court set as opposed to getting involved in a fast-paced transition game with the quicker Huskies.
Halftime statistically has shown not exactly sharp shooting from the floor, but at the same time, they've had such good rebounding that they're getting off 2, 3, 4 shots a clip, and that's deceiving. That's why the percentages are down. When you look at UNH, the second line down, 10 for 30, 33%. Northeastern is 35% and 13 for 37. Clip, your comments on that?
Not much to choose from, really. Northeastern has had more attempts, I think, because they want to play the game at a faster pace. When you run up and down the floor, as this team wants to do, you're probably going to get more attempts at the goal.
Jump down to the next to the last line. Free throws attempted. Is that a home court situation where a lot of times a home team will get the calls, or is it simply a matter of Northeastern being very aggressive and hacking a little bit?
Well, I think that UNH's penetration along the baseline, that flex offense that they run, they're looking for somebody down low. There's a lot of rebounding action, and because of that, they're able to get the line more times to Northeastern, which rely primarily on short jumpers and outside games.
Here's a breakdown of the high scorers for both teams. We already showed you highlights from Laura Side and Charlene Blake, the two leaders for UNH and Northeastern respectively. But Deb Doris has chipped in with 6 for UNH. And on the Northeastern side, Darlene Strong and Talitha Cox. Now, I think this is an impressive number for Laura Seiden defensively, holding Cox to just 6 points.
Cox is a stronger, older player. Seiden only a freshman. Cox has had 2 years of junior college basketball under her belt. She's a junior here. And Laura Seiden did have problems because of the strength of Cox getting low, down low on the post. Another thing we should mention, we had some pretty good contributions from UNH off the bench. Jen Casey, Allison Gagnon, and Deb Russell all made significant contributions for UNH in that first half.
Now, we mentioned Cox with only 6 points, but we should also add that her average is just under 9, so she's certainly within reach of her average, but I still expected a little bit more offensively from her, especially playing against Seiden, who before the game, we thought she'd be able to eat her up a little bit offensively.
Well, I think Cox, you know, as you said, is a very strong player, and UNH is aware of that. Talking to Coach Sanborn before the game, the reason they could go into that 3-2 matchup zone, the person they're matching up on is Cox. They're trying to front her in that zone so she doesn't, you know, get loose down low.
We're almost ready to tip off second half action. Right now, UNH holding on by a point. Plenty more basketball coming your way. Stay with us. We'll be back.
Unfortunately, you can't always pick your fellow traveler.
Hi, 22E. My name's Nadine. I'm a Pisces.
Have our paths crossed before?
Yes, they have. The Miss Bayou Belle hair pageant. I was first runner-up.
But you can pick a winner. Pick 3, pick 4. New Hampshire's Daily Numbers Game. The luck starts here.
Fish cakes are my favorites. You want your taters?
You know you're gonna shop, buy a Chevy and shop, get a great deal and shop, buy a Chevy and shop. Come on, y'all, Chevrolet,
Chevrolet,
Chevrolet.
Hey, the new Lumina four-door sedan has more headroom and more legroom than the Ford Taurus. And now there's even more reason to buy one, up to $1,050 cash back. Now, isn't that worth shouting about?
Buy a Chevy and shop, shop.
Welcome back live in Durham, New Hampshire, Lundholm Gymnasium on the campus of UNH. Jeff Bacon and Dave Olson ready to tip off second half action. The Wildcats of UNH against the Huskies of Northeastern. New Hampshire will take the ball out to begin second half play, leading by 1 point. The starting 5, Fitz, Donlin, Dorsch, Seiden, and Ryan for New Hampshire. Strong, Blake, Washington, Cox, and Harwell was not a starter, but she's in there right now for the Huskies.
Hillary Harwell had a very impressive first half.
Seiden on top, Cox all over her. Now Donlin takes the bounce pass. She's guarded by Blake, who had 9 points in the first half to lead the Huskies. Seiden with the ball and 13 points to begin second half play, leading all scorers. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Seiden fouled by Cox.
pretty good defense in that set there, as Northeastern was really aware when the ball was up top of what UNH people on the wings were doing. Let's watch it here as you see Seiden go up. Her shot didn't draw iron, but she was fouled at the foul line in the first half. She was 5-for-6. I waited long enough to say that.
Now she's 6-of-7. This is where the jinx comes in. Seiden with 14 points now. Cox with 2 fouls. And it's a 3-point lead now for New Hampshire with 19 and a half minutes to go in the game. Blake gets it out to Washington with Ryan all over her. UNH in that zone again. They played zone almost the entire afternoon, if not the entire afternoon. And the steal by Ryan bounced to side, man. UNH gets it back. Good defensive job.
Once again, in that 3-2 match, they're giving special attention to Cox in the middle.
They clog it up well. Ryan out to side, an easy shot there. Well, maybe it wasn't so easy. At least she had a shot.
Easy for you to say, Jeff.
What I meant to say was a wide open shot. Believe me, I've shot layups before. Those aren't even easy. It's always easier from this vantage point anyway.
Always is. It's all right. They tell me you were a great defensive player in your day, but you couldn't shoot a lick.
Well, I don't know about that either, defensively. Strong to Blake. UNH doing a good job collapsing in the middle. 10 seconds on the shot clock.
Really clogging it up down low.
And an errant pass. It could be backcourt violation. Fitz takes it. 2-on-1. Donlin.
A resident of Bow, New Hampshire, making the steal and the blind pass over to Donlin for the layup.
33-28, New Hampshire on top. Washington wanted the shot, decides to go baseline. In all kinds of traffic, Cordelia Washington with a good move.
Doing it with the pump.
Back to a 3-point game now, 33-30, New Hampshire. Seiden gets a nice pick from Donlin, bounces it off Cox's foot, and Carol Bitford rules it'll be New Hampshire's ball with 17:52 to go.
Actually, Seiden was looking to pass down low in that sequence to Ryan, who was breaking along the baseline.
Fitz wants it. Seiden manages to get it behind Cox. Inside to Ryan. Ryan is stuffed by Cox. Good call in my eyes by Jack Reardon. Good call.
Excellent call. A great defensive play by Cox blocking the shot from
Harwell's injured, number 23. She's Ryan. Injured underneath. She got hit in the eye, I believe, but she's okay. On the alternating possession, New Hampshire has the ball. Nice pass to Doris from Fitz. Foul called underneath. And Washington was just plain beaten.
Good recognition by Fitz to pick out the open Doris going towards the basket.
Non-shooting foul, New Hampshire's ball underneath. Fitz throws it in for the catch. Dorsch takes it. Leia Blake's one whale of a defensive player.
He likes that reach in.
He gets hammered by Cox, and that's number 3 for Talitha Cox.
Seiden very aware of where the defense is. We'll see her number 42 getting the ball. Look at her after she receives it. Create the contact using the ball fake to draw the defender and then just put the body on the defender to draw the contact.
You know, we've been ranting and raving about Seiden, and she deserves all the accolades that she's received, but Coach Kathy Sanborn says she's not even surprised at how well she's doing. She expected it.
No, she did. She knew when she scouted her last year that she would be an immediate starter for this team. A player who would, you know, replace Chris Kenny as well as somebody can in their freshman year.
Seiden has only missed 2 free throws in 10 attempts now, and it's a 34-30 game. New Hampshire with the lead. 17:20 to go in the game. Washington loses it, gets it back. What a 3-second call. The shot's no good. And it'll be New Hampshire's ball as Blake flies against the wall.
Pat's still packing it in inside. They don't want any any ball penetration into that paint area for one of the Northeastern players, namely Cox.
Dorsch in for side, who had to move on. What a whistle. Seiden and Harwell, that's not a good matchup for Northeastern there, because Seiden just posted right up on her and took it to the hoop.
She did. She was able to break in back of the defender as Harwell let her get by, get the pass, missed the initial shot, and then drew the contact, and once again, Laura Seiden going to the line.
Well, she's earning her keep at the charity stripe today. It's the 11th free throw. Now they just gave that point to Northeastern. On the scoreboard.
As long as we have Sid, we're in business.
36
scoreboard.
36-30, New Hampshire by six. Seiden buries two more from the line. Cordelia Washington with the ball, looking for somebody to throw it to, and Sue Ryan is in her face. Finally, throw to Harwell. It's out of bounds.
Terrific defensive set there by the Wildcats, and it was the overall team defense that caused that turnover.
Northeastern calls a timeout. UNH looking good in this second half. We'll be back.
The Cadillac DeVille, please.
In weather like this, you'll be happy to know the Cadillac DeVille has front-wheel drive, because that gives you better traction in the snow.
My town car, please.
On the other hand, Lincoln Town Car has never had front-wheel drive, and that could leave you out in the cold. With front-wheel drive and V8 power, you'll enjoy Cadillac style in any weather. So now's the perfect time to test drive a new DeVille at your Cadillac Trendsetter dealer.
I'm bored. The rumors are true. I can't keep pouring it on year after year. It's enough already. I'm leaving, all right? I won't play this game anymore. You know why? I've discovered it's time to change my serve.
Discover the one-calorie real cola taste worth leaving Pepsi for.
Just for the taste of it.
Goodbye, Pepsi. You think you're in. I say you're out.
Diet Coke.
You find it in promises, and you find it in plans, in the midst of laughter, and in silences shared. When the deal is sealed, and when the dance is done, it's there. And for 80 million responsible Americans, it's simply a good part of the good life. It's beer. A message from Budweiser.
Michelle Grenier from middle on the bench there, and to her right is Deb Russell. To her left, Allison Gagnon. So three freshmen of the six, and it's a good freshman class for the Wildcats.
Part of the kiddie core that will be the future of UNH basketball here on the women's side for years to come.
Donlin's three-pointer is good. 39-30, New Hampshire.
Kind of knew when that left her hand from our vantage point that that was going to tickle its wine.
That's her second three-pointer this afternoon. And it's tipped out of bounds by Fitz.
You know, Jeff, we're 4 minutes and 2 seconds into the second half, and Northeastern has had only one field goal.
New Hampshire by nine. Underneath, it's Blake. Now she gets it to Harwell. Good job. Nice pass to Harwell, and Northeastern cuts the lead to seven.
Nice pass to Harwell, who was loose on the weak side.
Ryan cross court. Michelle Brusso, another New Hampshire native in there as well.
What a great move.
Two boards. Laura Seiden now has 20 points.
Nice low post move by Seiden, who finally got three on the block. She turned once, didn't have a shot, came back the other way, and put it in.
Harwell down low has it. Seiden almost kicked it away. Try to get her foot in there. That's Blake. Washington from the free throw line gets it to roll.
Cats still packing in, forcing the Huskies to take those outside shots because nothing is available in the paint.
9 points for Cordelia Washington. That score is incorrect that you saw on the screen. It's 41-34, Northeastern trailing by seven. Fitz can't get it to fall. And New Hampshire will keep it. It goes out of bounds off Jessica Arnold. We talked about Julie Donlin in a three-pointer. Get a look at Joy Marchioti, the head coach at Northeastern in her ninth season. Julie Donlin isn't scoring as much this year. We talked a little bit before the game, and she suggested a lot of it had to do with the tempo of the game. She likes an up-tempo game a little bit more. It's been a little bit adjustment for it. It's half-court style. A nice pass. Ryan can't get it to fall. Foul called on Michelle Brown.
Well, as a team's personnel changes, sometimes you have to change your style of play, too. And in an up-tempo game, you will get more attempts at the goal. We saw that in our halftime statistics. Northeastern wants to run. They took seven more field goal attempts.
Laura Seiden with a beautiful inbounds play. They had four different UNH Wildcats screening her out for that shot, or three, I should say. She put it up and in. 22 points now for Seiden. It's a 9-point game, 43-34 New Hampshire. 14:20 to go in the game. Washington, they're letting her take it. Rebound Ryan.
This particular group that's on the floor for Northeastern, according to scouting reports, the UNH had, isn't particularly adept at shooting from the outside.
They gave Fitz the three-pointer there, but she didn't want it. Donlin did a nice job just getting the ball up court there. Russo underneath the side, double teamed, has to clear it out. Donlin wants three more. Yes. Julie Donlin, 9 points off three-pointers and another bucket gives her 11. And that can put you to sleep in a hurry if you're Northeastern.
And every time she hits one, it's a new UNH record for her career.
Her record in a game is 6. She's done it already this season, breaking her old mark of 5.
Last year, just to give you an idea, she hit 47 three-baggers.
Washington, nice bouncer underneath, but in all kinds of traffic. Ryan gets the steal for New Hampshire with 13:15 to go. UNH can really put it to him now. Michelle Brusso, a walk-on, throws it all the way across the side. Harwell comes to meet her. Ryan can't handle it, and Harwell ties her up. This time it'll be Northeastern ball in the alternating possession. Back into the game, number 32 for Northeastern, Talitha Cox, and Marilyn Oates is in for the first start. She's a 5'11 sophomore from Jamaica, New York, number 30.
All the attention that Cox has gotten thus far from the Wildcats, unofficially, I only have her for 2 points, Jeff. So it's paid off.
Strong just takes it up. One shot, rebound Donlin. They're going to try to speed things up here.
Didn't have the numbers to take it further, so Donlin pulled it back out.
And a foul away from the ball on Sue Ryan, number 22. That's just her first. 46-34, New Hampshire with 12:49 to go. Michelle Brown on the bench for Northeastern.
Cats back in at 3-2 now.
Strong comes out to take it from Blake.
Cox
in the middle. Russo. And Russo doing the job. Gets fouled from behind by Cox. That's number 4 for her. Kathy Sandborn in her fourth season at UNH. The 1989 Coach of the Year in the Seaboard Conference has some instructions for Tri-Captain Jeff Dorsch. Bringing in Joy Marchioti. A couple of very good coaches on the floor this afternoon.
Jeff Dorsch back into the ball game. One player we haven't talked much about, or one situation, is the number one guard, Julie Donlin, and the number two guard, the shooting guard, Shelley Fitz. You look at their numbers, and they don't equal their position. Because Fitz doesn't score as much as Donlin, but Donlin handles.
But Fitz is a tremendous defensive player.
Great defensive player, very underrated rebounder, always drawing the opponent's toughest offensive player. And it's interesting about two of the three tri-captains here for UNH, Fitz and George. As freshmen and sophomores, they did not start a ball game for the Wildcats. And by the time their junior year came, they were starters on a nightly basis.
Laura Seiden called for that foul. It's just her second. Foul called. We're going to count it.
Big time move right there.
That's Cordelia Washington.
Let's watch it here again. Washington gets the ball. UH collapses between two defenders. Through the contact. In the hoop.
Rita McCarroll has come to the game for New Hampshire. Laura Seiden will get a break. Washington, not a bad free throw shooter. He completes a three-point play.
Washington has had 7 of the 9 points here in the second half for Northeastern.
It's a 9-point game now. New Hampshire with 11:58 to go, 46-37 the score. Fitz gets a roll rebound, puts it down, trouble. And that was a good move by Fitz. She knew she was going to get fouled, and she just threw it up so she could go to the line for a pair. A
couple of good moves there by Shelly Fitz. First of all, she took the open shot when it presented itself. She missed the shot, but she followed her miss, got the offensive rebound, and put it back up. Got fouled, and she'll go to the line.
This is only her second free throw shot this year. She's 0 for 1.
You look at Shelly Fitz in the loss to Fairfield. She played 39 minutes. Was 3 for 5 from the field, had 7 rebounds, 2 on the offensive glass, 2 blocks, 2 steals, and 1 assist. Very fine all-around game, and she's one of those players whose true value actually transcends her statistical line.
That's her first point of the game. It's a 10-point ball game now. New Hampshire up by 10, 47-37. Kick by Fitz. It'll be Northeastern's ball. They're going to reset the shot clock.
In basketball, like any other sport.
Let me interrupt you, Dave. Queen Mouth Shorty, she's an animated coach on that bench, I'll tell you.
I don't want to interview her.
Blake inside to Cox, double team. McCarroll and Doris both slammed it down. New Hampshire will take over. Good job there. Putting it up in traffic might not have been the wise move there.
Talked about Shelly Fitz's value transcending her statistics. On the other end of the spectrum, there are certain players who hang big numbers, but at crunch time, you wouldn't want the ball in their hands because they'll break your heart with 15 seconds to go every time.
But Carol DeDors misses the turnaround rebound. Washington, and it is now strong, bringing it up for Northeastern.
Washington went up very strong for that ball.
Washington with the rebound. And look at, she's smothered by 3 New Hampshire players. All 3 held their hands up, and she just went up into it and threw the foul.
We have a chance. Maybe we can look at that in a minute because nobody got a body on Washington. You had 3 players for UNH surrounding her, but nobody fronting her to keep her off the offensive glass.
And the foul was called, I believe, on Fitz. No, Rita McCarroll just,
watch
one of 3 could get it, too.
Number 21 slipping right in there. Nobody around her. Nobody got a body on her.
They call it on the tallest player underneath. Washington hits the free throws, and it's 47-39 with 10:45 to go. Donlan trying to put the move on Blake. Great pass underneath to Michelle Brusso, who couldn't get it in. She was falling away on that shot. A couple of defenders came up to meet her, and the rebound goes out to Darlene Strong.
Again, the screen down low got Michelle Brusso free along the baseline.
Marilyn Oates with it. Averaging just under 6 points a game. Kicked by Brusso. Interesting situation here, and I think it says something for New Hampshire women's college basketball in the high school ranks. You've got 3 New Hampshire natives on the floor right now. In Donlin, Brusso, and Fitz.
Homebred models.
And for a long time, that was not the case here in New Hampshire. Many sports. Cox rocks.
Well, you know, Jeff, below the college basketball level, there's a lot more year-round basketball taking place with the emergence of the AAU programs. And kids from New Hampshire getting more exposure to other players from other states. Thus, we're getting a better product at this level.
Dorsey's pass intercepted by Cox. 47-39, New Hampshire, 9:48 to go in the game. Strong gets it through to Blake. Blake blocked by McCarroll. Fitz loses it. Strong fouled by McCarroll this time. Rita McCarroll, her second foul.
So far in this half, UNH has outscored Northeastern 18-10.
UNH by 8.
A four-door sedan has more headroom and more legroom than the Ford Taurus. And now there's even more reason to buy one. Up to $1,050 cash back. Now, isn't that worth shouting about?
Buy a Chevy and shout!
This is it, honey. I'm leaving you. I don't care how cool you think you are, how many generations you say adore you. You just don't excite me anymore. And don't give me that sweet routine. It's just not my style. I've discovered a real pop star.
Discover the one-calorie, real color taste worth leaving Pepsi for.
Goodbye, Pepsi. Diet Coke, let's rock and roll.
Ow! Diet Coke!
Unfortunately, you can't always pick your fellow traveler.
Hi, 22E. My name's Nadine. I'm a Pisces.
Have our paths crossed before?
Yes, they have. The Miss Bayou Belle hair pageant. I was first runner-up.
But you can pick a winner. Pick three, pick four. New Hampshire's Daily Numbers Game. The luck starts here.
Fish cakes are my favorites. You want your taters?
This program reminder, John Belushi is in for the shock of his life when Dan Aykroyd moves his wacky family next door in Neighbors, this week's Cinema 9 presentation. Now on Sunday night at midnight. That's Neighbors, tomorrow night at midnight on WWR-TV. Northeastern's ball, it's an 8-point lead for New Hampshire. Blake goes down.
Blake certainly drew some attention down low from the Wildcats as Deb Dorsch and Sue Ryan kind of ganged up on her down there.
Ryan will get called for that foul, her second. Still not a bonus situation for Northeastern, although UNH is in a bonus situation on the next foul. Strong and Blake have been a point at the guard slots almost the entire afternoon. In fact, I don't think they've gone to the bench yet. And Blake misses the move on that one. From Washington with the rebound, stripped right out of her hands by Ryan. It's Fitz slowing things down.
By Fitz, the numbers were going against her. If he came on, went from 1-on-1 to 1-on-3, so Shelley pulled it back out.
Deb Dorsch, the tri-captain, along with Fitz and Rita McCarroll. Now Seiden has it. Seiden's been quiet. She's taking a breather. She's back in now. Another way across for Seiden, and a blind block by Blake, who's on her horse down the other way. 3-on-1. Shelley Fisk knocks it out. Good job there, cutting in front of Strong.
In terms of positional defense, Blake making that interception, her position was horrible. Her back.
In football, that would have been a penalty.
Oh, would have been a penalty. She was facing the defender, couldn't see the ball, but yet had the athletic ability to get the hand up and cause a turnover.
47-39 New Hampshire. In the middle, Cox has to get it up with the 3-second call. Rebound, Cordelia Washington, who's done it all in the second half. Rebound now, Dorsch for UNH.
Cats continue to throw a blanket on.
Shelly Fitz, Concord High grad. Now Donley, the Lehigh grad. This is a free throw. It's her first 3-point miss, I think, this afternoon. On the other end, Donley. That's good, man, Blake.
That was what you call a major league foul.
That's Donlin's first foul. Get another look here. Blake just on her horse, and Donlin comes right from the left of your screen to tag her. Good, I'll tell you. It's a Danny Ainge type foul.
Danny Ainge type foul, or a like an NFL defensive back breaking up a pass. That would have been an interference too, Jeff.
Blake having some trouble from the line this season. 42.9%.
That that open court sequence, you could see the speed with the ball that Blake has, and Donlin did well to catch up with her. In fact, the only reason Julie did was because she had the angle coming from the other side.
That's Blake's first point of this second half after leading Northeastern with 9 in the first half. First 2 for 2, she has 11 now, and it's 47-41, UNH. Approaching the 8-minute mark to go in this game. The ECAC North Atlantic Conference opener for the Cats. Northeastern already with one conference loss to Maine. They were crunched in that game.
Very important for UNH now with a 6-point lead. Less than 8 minutes to go. Run your offense effectively. Get the good opportunities for good shots.
Side misses. Rebound Blake, and they're trying to keep this tempo up. And Blake just throws up an awkward shot.
Looked like she might have turned that ball over, and it was no call, Jeff, on the way down.
7.5 minutes to go now. Donald slowing things down. All the way across from George to side. Puts the move on Cox. Cox can't foul. And Donald left-handed. Rebound goes to Marilyn Oaks.
That cross-court pass to the weak side has been open all afternoon for UNH.
And you might notice Cox is a little timid underneath there playing against side because Cox has 4 fouls. One shy of the limit. Down to 10 seconds on the shot clock. Cox turn around. Side foul. Is that a foul on Cox? If it is, she's done.
It is.
Talitha Cox fouls on with 6:56 to go. And that will certainly hurt the Huskies there. Hillary Harwell comes into the game. I don't know if she's coming in to replace Cox. So Joy Malshoney has a decision to make, and she will send in Jessica Arnold.
Jessica Arnold was a major force in the first half on the glass. And there you see side 83% from the charity strike.
10 of 12. Allison Gagnon is coming to the game for New Hampshire. Julie Donlin is a breather side with 23 points per game. I think that's 23 today. Her average is actually 17.9 per game.
In the Holiday Classic down at Central Florida, Jeff, she scored 65 points in 3 games and shot 59% from the field. Not too shabby.
6:45 to go in the game. Strong to Washington. Arnold in the middle. And Strong hits.
Those are Strong's first points of the second half, but she showed us a pretty good outside shooting touch in that first half.
Strong now has 8 points, has a couple of players approaching double figures for the Huskies, in addition to Blake. Siding to Doris with 6:20 to go. Doris misses. Strong scoops it up.
All black shirts up on that glass that time after the missed shot.
Strong bounces left to Blake, has baseline again. Nice move by Blake. Won't go. Rebound.
Blake just
Karen
flat
McCoy.
Out. Blake just flat out missed that shot. She had a clear lane right to the hoop. But she's still a man.
Side very good.
Laura Seiden is showing the folks at home this afternoon today, here today, why she's such an outstanding freshman and what all the noise is about here at UNH.
25 points for Laura Seiden. Northeastern will keep it.
Jen Casey coming in from Kelly Fitz.
Blake bounces to Strong again. Steve! Rebound Cordelia Washington, no good. Behind gets hammered by Hillary Harwell.
Very good position. We talked about getting good position when going to rebound, and that time Deb Dorsch had very good position down low. She had Harwell in back of her. And there you see the Northeastern bench.
Joy Malshoney. Well-respected coach, though. very, very good job with this program over the last 8 years at Northeastern. One of the winningest coaches in New England, active-wise, in terms of percentage. Jed Dorsch with 7 points. She averages 14.1, so she's obviously below that so far this afternoon. But Laura Seiden picking up the slack at 25 points. And it's back to a 9-point UNH lead. 5:10 to go. Gagnon all over Blake.
Great defense in this set right here by UNH.
And almost thrown away. Backcourt violation. And that's one of those where you kind of wonder why they called that, because as far as Strong was concerned, she thought that because it was touched by UNH, I don't know if it was.
Some confusion there. We have 4:57 to go. Cats by 9.
When he heard the news, he left in haste. Didn't want to miss that big, bold taste.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
It's beef from McDonald's, a quarter pound on a toasted rye bun, but it won't stay around.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
With cheddar cheese sauce, grilled onions too, it's a big, bold taste, too good to be true.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
Cheddar Melt.
For a limited time.
To go.
At McDonald's.
The Cadillac DeVille, please.
In weather like this, you'll be happy to know the Cadillac DeVille has front-wheel drive, because that gives you better traction in the snow.
My town car, please.
On the other hand, Lincoln Town Car has never had front-wheel drive, and that could leave you out in the cold. With front-wheel drive and V8 power, you'll enjoy Cadillac style in any weather. So now's the perfect time to test drive a new DeVille at your Cadillac Trendsetter dealer.
Unfortunately, you can't always pick your fellow traveler.
Hi, 22E. My name's Nadine. I'm a Pisces.
Have our paths crossed before?
Yes, they have. The Miss Bayou Belle hair pageant. I was first runner-up.
But you can pick a winner. Pick 3, pick 4. New Hampshire's Daily Numbers Game. The luck starts here.
Fish cakes are my favorites. You want your taters?
Dave Olson, let's look at this, because apparently it was a bad call. They may reverse this decision here.
You see the ball batted away by Gagnon of UNH from the Northeastern dribbler. She goes back, picks the ball up. You see her foot in the backcourt.
She never had possession, though, so I think by rights that should not have been a backcourt violation.
If the ball was touched by UNH last before it went over, and that's the contention of the Northeastern people. We've had a rather long a conference during that timeout between the officials. There you see Kathy Sanborn.
Now earlier, Joy Malshoti, as you get a look at her now in the huddle, had come and protested, and right now they're trying to discuss whether or not they are going to overturn that call. I saw official Jack Reardon and asked Carol Bickford, who made if a white person with a white jersey did touch the ball.
He
said, he goes, did a white player touch the ball? He goes, yes, white number 15 touched it, and I think they may overrule that, so we'll have to decide what happened.
Sort this one out. At any rate, we have 4:57 to go. UNH is in a 52-43 lead.
Still trying to get a ruling. I think they are going to give it to New Hampshire still. Well, this is one of those where we don't have the extra ear to listen to what exactly happened. It looked like it should be Northeastern's ball and just an incorrect call, but
from our vantage point, it looked that way.
The replay.
We couldn't pick up the entire dialogue between the officials and the coaches.
And they might have determined that she had possession of the ball before she crossed over that line. In this case, then it is a backcourt violation.
Pretty good cut there by Dorsch down low, and Gagnon trying to feed her. Ball batted away, but UNH will retain possession.
4:41 to go, 52-43. Wildcats on top. Dorsch to Casey. Strong out on her in the middle. Side wants to turn around. No good. Rebound Arnold, who didn't even jump for that. She just stuck her hands up and grabbed it.
Been very effective on the boards today, Jessica Arnold has.
Darlene Blake.
Not much movement in this Husky offense right now.
Harwell back out to Strong. Taken away by Casey. They call Casey for a foul. That's her first this afternoon.
Foul number 33, Jennifer Casey. Her first personal. Darlene Strong should be 1-1.
I'll tell you, David, the last few years that we've covered women's basketball, be it college or high school, I don't think I've seen a coach, even on the men's side for that matter, as animated as Moshody. No good, but the rebound, Hillary Harwell, and a good job there underneath, because many times in a foul situation, you're going to give it a rebound to the defensive team, and Gagnon wants a timeout for New Hampshire with a 7-point lead, 3:58 to go. We'll be back.
It began as a game. It turned into a battle. And now, it's out of control. Bud Bowl 2. Coming January 28th. This time, it's war.
The Cadillac DeVille, please.
In weather like this, you'll be happy to know the Cadillac DeVille has front-wheel drive, because that gives you better traction in the snow.
My town car, please.
On the other hand, Lincoln Town Car has never had front-wheel drive, and that could leave you out in the cold. With front-wheel drive and V8 power, you'll enjoy Cadillac style in any weather. So now's the perfect time to test drive a new DeVille at your Cadillac Trendsetter dealer.
We do have a ruling on that backcourt violation mini controversy. Apparently the ruling was that New Hampshire never gained possession of the ball on the steal, so consequently it was still considered Northeastern's ball, and that was why they determined it was a backcourt violation. Now that mystery is solved. UNH is trying to solve the mystery of the Northeastern defense with a 7-point lead, trying to add to that with 3:45 to go in the game. Donlin doing the job, one-on-one, dribbling against Blake. Now Seiden has the lane. A little short, Forrest rebound off her foot. No trip called, McCoy gets it.
Hey, Donald looked like she had a notion out here to put up the trifecta, and you could have made a case for her being fouled.
Donald, nice pass to Side. Way short again. Side a little cold and late going here after a blazing first three quarters of the game. Julie Donlin and Cordelia Washington battle for it. Jump ball called. And the possession this time goes to Northeastern.
Cordelia Washington had the ball on the deck, and she was looking up to find somebody to pass to. Donlin just reached in and got a hand on it.
Time running out for Northeastern, trailing by 7. We're approaching the 3-minute mark. And they're not going to do much from the three-point line. That you mentioned, they've taken 13 three-pointers all season. So they're going to do it down in the digs.
Cats in that matchup again.
Harwell hammered by, I can't see who it is yet. Is it Ryan?
I think it's going to be on Ryan.
Yep, that's who it is. They call that on Deb Dorsch? Interesting call. I thought it was on Ryan, but it's number one for Dorsch.
He's 1-1. It's very important the Northeastern convert here.
Well, they'll take that just as well. Charlene Blake. That's the second time the Cats have been burned under the boards on a defensive position with Northeastern at the line.
Well,
hate to see that.
I said it earlier, and I'll say it again. So important when that shot goes up that you get a body on somebody and establish good position to rebound.
52-47. That lead, 9-point lead at one time. Actually, it was as much as 12 for UNH. It's down to 5, but Donlin is fouled from behind by Blake, her fourth.
Blake trying that reach around move. That time drew a body and not ball.
Donlin to the line for 1-1.
Just as it was important for Northeastern to make hay on these 1-1s, it's just as important for UNH.
Swish.
One shot.
Now, let's set that microphone in a good place. You can hear that net tingle nicely. Of course, you can hear it rattle, too, but underneath, Karen McCoy.
Her first hoop of the ball game, and a big one it is, as it extends the Wildcat lead 55-47.
That turns into a three-point play for UNH.
Not a bad exchange.
2:20 to go. Washington off the front, rebound McCoy. And we talked about McCoy's rebounding prowess, and she's displaying it again this afternoon.
Two big ones here down the stretch.
All the way across again, Seiden. Washington lost it. Donlin threw it underneath. It went off of Oates. Now there's a whistle. And it'll be New Hampshire's ball.
Donlin was looking to come in from the angle and get McCoy down low.
We're under 2 minutes to go. 55-47 UNH. Pitts has a shot. Has to stop now.
Take care of the basketball. Don't turn it over. Get good shots.
McCoy fouled by Marilyn Oates.
Those are the keys to UNH here in the last minute and 43 seconds.
Karen McCoy averaging just over 3 points a game, but again, we complained about her rebounding. About 43 to go. McCoy will go to the line, but we're going to take a break first.
You know you're going to shout, buy a Chevy and get a great deal and shout, buy a Chevy and shout, come on, y'all.
Chevy trucks are really worth shouting about. Not only do they come with Instatrack 4x4 so you can shift on the fly, now they come with up to $1,250 cash back. And that's not too tough to take.
Find a Chevy and shout!
Hi, sis. Hi, Mom. Any cold Pepsi?
Not in this house, Johnny King. Not anymore.
Gee, how come?
Because we've discovered something else.
Well, looks like Johnny's discovering Diet Coke is the one calorie taste worth leaving Pepsi for. Now with three cans free in the 15-pack. Plenty for family and friends.
Hey, Mom, with three cans of Diet Coke free, there's enough for the gang.
Just for the taste of it.
Oh, Johnny.
Diet Coke.
Trap rotation, guard, you come up, double the ball, corraler, don't foul. You gotta be ready to come up on 24. Bell come up, D come up, Marilyn, watch the back. Slay of reference.
Go, Black.
Well, that's about as calm as I've seen Joy Mouse Shoddy this afternoon. With an 8-point deficit right now. Karen McCoy to the line, she's 5-for-10 this season.
Joy was telling her team to trap the ball handler and watch for the backside cut. They do trap somebody because Shelly Fitz may be open.
Yeah. 1:43 remaining. McCoy extends that New Hampshire lead to 9 with one more shot.
Little lane violation.
Let's say you can hear that sneaker squeak outside.
That hesitation move by McCoy on the foul shot.
A nice fake from the line by McCoy.
Good ball fake.
Never seen that done before.
Watch it. Goes down. Sets and delivers.
Well, so we got another try, but it doesn't go through. Hillary Harwell with a rebound. Northeastern trailing by 9. 1:35 to go. Notice no dribbling, they're just passing. Travel, Washington.
Most coaches like to see that. Keep the ball off the deck, move it, advance it in the air, but the movement of the ball was on the perimeter. Northeastern is all afternoon has been looking inside, and that just has not been open.
Strong got away with a foul there on Donlin. Underneath, Seiden.
Seiden got that ball on the low block from Donlin. Showed the defender the ball who flew by, and then she had the open layup.
Nice assist by Donlin. 1 minute to go in this game. Foul called on Julie Donlin, and that was one of those she'd love to have back. That's her second.
See how Northeastern plays this after the free throw attempt because they need the basketball.
Darlene Strong hits the first. Strong has 9 points.
The two big offensive weapons for Northeastern, Blake and Cox. Blake has only had 4 second-half points. Cox is scoreless. Of course, she's fouled out, so.
That was a big loss for the Huskies with Talitha Cox. And a careless pass by Donlin off of Fitz. And Kathy Sanborn telling him just to calm down. They got a 9-point lead with 48 seconds remaining.
A little surprised the Huskies aren't more aggressive in extending that defense given the situation.
Washington, it's short. Hart was there, and she just threw it up hoping to draw the foul. No call. McCoy, though, will foul Charlie Blake, and this again gives us an opportunity, if you joined us late, to remind you that in a game like this with a 9-point game in 34 seconds, many times you could say anything can happen with this 3-point shot, but for Northeastern that isn't the case. They do not take that 3-pointer very often, and when they do, they don't hit very often.
And yet they have a player, Darlene Strong, who has showed some prowess on the outside this afternoon.
34 seconds to go, UNH by 9.
Unfortunately, you can't always pick your fellow traveler.
Hi, 22E. My name's Nadine. I'm a Pisces.
Have our paths crossed before?
Yes, they have. The Miss Bayou Belle hair pageant. I was first runner-up.
But you can pick a winner. Pick 3, pick 4. New Hampshire's Daily Numbers Game. The luck starts here.
Fish cakes are my favorites. You want your taters?
When he heard the news, he left in haste. Didn't want to miss that big, bold taste.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
It's beef from McDonald's, a quarter pound, on a toasted rye bun, but it won't stay around.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
With cheddar cheese sauce, grilled onions too, it's a big, bold taste, too good to be true.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
Cheddar Melt.
For a limited time. To go. At McDonald's.
Program reminder for you that WWF Wrestling has moved to a new time on WMUR. Now you can catch all your favorite WWF superstars every Saturday night at 11:30, right after the Night Report. That's right here on WMUR TV, Channel 9. The Hulkster and all his buddies. With 34 seconds remaining in the top right of your screen, you'll see the clock. UNH with a 9-point lead. Charlene Blake to the line. Blake with 9 points in the first half, held to just 4 here in the second for a 13 for a total over her average of 10.4 a game. And a key free throw missed there. Coy foul from behind by Marilyn Oates. And that's to be expected with 32 seconds to go, trailing by 9. The Huskies got to get it back, so they're going to foul.
I think you can count on seeing several tips to the foul line here in the last 32 seconds of play. As you said, the Huskies need that ball, trailing by 9. And Karen McCoy will try to extend that lead for the Wildcats.
1-for-2 from the line this afternoon. And it's a 10-point lead.
2-for-3, and she drew one line violation, too.
Was that quiet, or was that... Jump ball. Dorsch ties it up with Harwell. Good job. Not a bad crowd on hand. No. And considering the size of the crowd, I'd probably say that's made about 200 probably?
Probably, and once again...
Which is good for a women's game, and the students still out of camp, out of school, but they won't be back till the 21st.
That's right.
And it's just amazing how quiet they are when the New Hampshire player's at the line. We're down to 26 seconds. Another jump ball. This time the Huskies get it, and in that regard, that's the type of strategy you need. When you know it's your ball, you got to tie it up, and you know, that's a good way to get it back without fouling.
See the roll in here by Northeastern, because until that ball is touched, the clock doesn't start.
Darlene Strong with a double pump underneath the Harwell. Dorsch is behind her, and Harwell with a good fake and a nice hoop there.
A lot of acrobatic basketball in that sequence by Darlene Strong and Hillary Harwell.
4 seconds to go. Foul called there, and that's a meaningless foul there with an 8-point margin. Strong commits the foul number three for her.
Laura Seiden shooting one and one.
With 2 seconds to go, Laura Seiden will just try to beef up her stats a little bit. And we ask you to stay with us because following the game, we've got a few minutes to talk live with one or more players in today's game.
And we'll be right back here next week, Jeff.
That's right, it'll be UNH and UVM in another women's contest.
And if you're wearing dark green tie, we'll know where your feelings are.
Well, green and gold, right? Strong throws it up at the buzzer, and New Hampshire wins its conference opener 61-51 over Northeastern. The Wildcats now go to 4-7. Northeastern drops to 3-11. There's the final score, but we'll be back with post-game interviews, so don't go away.
You know you're gonna shop, buy a Chevy and shop, get a great deal and shop, buy a Chevy and shop. Come on, y'all, Chevrolet,
Chevrolet,
Chevrolet.
Hey, the new Lumina four-door sedan has more headroom and more legroom than the Ford Taurus. And now there's even more reason to buy one. Up to $1,050 cash back. Now, isn't that worth shouting about?
Buy a Chevy and shout! Shout!
Unfortunately, you can't always pick your fellow traveler.
Hi, 22E. My name's Nadine. I'm a Pisces.
Have our paths crossed before?
Yes, they have. The Miss Bayou Belle hair pageant. I was first runner-up.
But you can pick a winner. Pick three, pick four. New Hampshire's Daily Numbers Game. The luck starts here.
Fish cakes are my favorites. You want your taters?
Michelob Dry introduces the 20-ounce dry. The one dry for two. Rainy nights aren't much fun. Except when it's pouring inside. Shouldn't your night belong to Michelob Light?
When he heard the news, he left in haste. Didn't want to miss that big, bold taste.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
It's beef from McDonald's, a quarter pound, on a toasted rye bun, but it won't stay around.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
With cheddar cheese sauce, grilled onions too, it's a big, bold taste, too good to be true.
McDonald's Cheddar Melts.
Cheddar Melts.
For a limited time.
To go.
At McDonald's.
Today's game is brought to you by McDonald's, where it's always a good time for the great taste. By Diet Coke, from the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Northern New England. By New Hampshire Sweeps, the Granite States Lottery. By the Chevy Dealers of New England, start where more people end up. And by Budweiser, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. Final score at the University of New Hampshire, 61, Northeastern University, 51. The ECAC North Atlantic Conference opener, a successful one for the Wildcats at home, and a good TV appearance for Julie Donlin, among others. 12 points, Julie, in front of the home crowd. You're from New Hampshire, from Newt. 12 points, 3 three-pointers. Your quick assessment on the game, a little tough in the early going, but then you poured it on at the end.
Yeah, I think we were a little tentative at first. You know, once we got our defense together, found out who our shooters were, packed it in zone, we played good defense.
Were you concerned about Northeastern's running game? At first, they seemed to outrun you pretty well.
We were. Transition was a key. Coach Sanborn had told us we had to get back right away. She knew that would be one of our problems, so we tried to, you know, do what she said, and we got the job done.
We just got to look at one of your three-pointers. You did not seem too hesitant to throw it up, although you only threw your 3-for-4 from the three-point line. Not bad.
Yeah, the first one was an air ball, but after I got that under my system, I guess that was okay.
You lost to Fairfield by 4 points, but they're a tough team. Was that a big catalyst for you going into this game, playing so well in spite of losing?
I think it was, yeah. Fairfield, it wasn't a conference game. It helped us out. You know, we've been playing a lot of tough teams. We went down to the Duke tournament. We just got back from Florida. It feels good to play at home again.
Okay, Julie, congratulations on the win, and now we'll bring in Laura Seiden, the game-high 29 points. Laura, it's Talitha Cox, everybody thought that she was going to do a good job on you defensively, but that wasn't the case, and she fouled trouble early, too, for her.
Yeah, well, we worked really well together as a team. I thought we passed well, and we just worked well together, and I think that I got open a lot just because, you know, we were working together, and I took the shots, and I was open.
Not bad from the free throw line either, Laura. 13 of 16. Did you expect to draw that many fouls?
No, I didn't expect that many fouls. But with the foul line, we have been working a lot as a team on our foul shots, especially lately. So I think maybe that helps.
Talk about the difference first half, second half. Again, as Julie mentioned, you were able to collapse down and stuff up the middle pretty well in the second half. First half, they were doing a pretty good job inside on you.
Yeah, halftime coach really emphasized that we pack it in and help each other out on defense, and that's what we did. I think we did a good job.
I know TV-wise, the next game we're concerned about is Vermont. They are struggling a little bit this year, but at the same time, a big rivalry. Can you talk about next week's game with Vermont? I know you got a little bit in between, but just look ahead, if you will.
Well, I think we're going to do well. We've had a lot of tough games. You know, we might have not have won them, but they weren't conference games, and they were tough opponents, and I think we've been playing well, and hopefully we'll keep it up.
I know you want to get out and take a shower, but I'm going to keep you here a little bit longer. We've got a couple more minutes. I just want to go back to your situation. You've been averaging, you do better and better every game. I mean, you're averaged 17.9 points going into the game, but you've scored 26 points, 29 points today, the second time or third time. I think you've scored 29 this season. When you came here, Kathy Sanborn says she expected this kind of stuff out of you. Did you expect to be able to perform this well as far as the statistics are concerned?
I didn't really put any expectations on myself as far as statistics. I don't think I ever did. I just wanted to come in and try as hard as I could and play as well as I could. And Coach Sanborn did say that I would have the opportunity to, you know, to get in there. So I try to make the best of it.
Okay, congratulations, Laura Seiden. Again, the final, New Hampshire 61, Northeastern 51. Don't forget, next week we'll be right back at 1 o'clock with the UNH women taking on Vermont. For Dave Olson, our statistician Sid Slark, I'm Jeff Bacon. Thanks for joining us, and so long from Lundholm Gymnasium.
The Bruins were hot with the shots, but the Rangers turned it up a notch to hand the Bees a tough loss at home this afternoon. The highlights are next when New Hampshire at 6 continues.
Sooner or later, you'll break down and join AAA. Maybe you should do it now. With AAA, you're only a phone call away from getting help 24 hours a day anywhere. We'll start your car, change your flat, deliver gas, even tow you. To join, call the AAA office nearest you.
For great personal service and low everyday prices, check the lineup at your neighborhood True Value hardware store, where the 20-inch Master Mechanic Toolbox is the January True Value of the Month. It features a lift-out tote tray and roomy bottom storage. Plus, it protects your tools from the weather and all kinds of abuse. In January, this Master Mechanic Toolbox is just $9.99 where you see the banner at participating True Value hardware stores and home center.
If you're confined to one of these, time and the world stand still. But your expenses don't. Through no fault of your own, your life, your dreams are on hold. Perhaps this will change. Until then, who will pay the costs of all this? Who will take care of your family's needs? Call us. We're the law firm of Stephen R. Fine and Associates. We're skilled in personal injury cases. Our fees come from monies collected for you.
No matter what car you think you want to own in 1990, be sure Suzuki is on your list.
because Grupponi Suzuki has factory incentives up to $3,000. Hard top or soft top, city streets or country roads, Suzuki has the right model for you, and Grupponi has incentives to save you $3,000. Break through the snow barrier with Samurai and Sidekick JX 4x4s, and look at these delivered prices.
You know, they played pretty aggressively this afternoon, but the Bruins just couldn't pull it together.
This is one of those where when Mike Milbury looks at the tape of this thing, he's just going to say, what are you going to do? 37 shots to the Rangers, 17 shots, but they couldn't put enough in goal. And, you know, the bottom line, if you get more goals, you win. It's amazing how that works. The Red Hot Bruins were cooled down a little by the New York Rangers this afternoon at the Garden. 3-2 was the final. The loss snaps a five-game Bruins win streak, and it comes against the last-place team in the Patrick division. Mike Milbury had to wonder what his guys had to do to score. They would score in the first, though, trailing 1-0. Kenny Linsman drops it back for Ray Bourque, who smacks it into the far corner to tie the game at one apiece after one. Then the Bees go up by one in the second. Gary Galley shoots, and Bobby Carpenter knocks it in. Boston is on top 2-1. But late in the second, Brian Mullen scores his second goal of the game. Watch from the left of your screen, Bobby Carpenter diving, and the puck deflects off his stick into the net past Reggie Lemelin. 2-2 after two, and with under a minute to play in regulation, the Rangers come up big.
Hit the post just to the left of Lemelin. The Sandstrom almost put it, and they win it. Sandstrom pokes it in. Not win, 34 seconds left.
Sounds wins, right, Fred? They did eventually win. Rangers go up 3-2. That's it. The final. Bruins skate at Hartford Monday night. College hockey. For the third time this season and the sixth time in the last 11 meetings, UNH and Providence skate into overtime. And once again, they end in a tie this time. Last time they went to overtime, triple overtime. Remember the Jokins Comforting Classic? Providence ended up winning that one. St. A's falls to Elmira. On to basketball, where the Celtics are in Miami tonight to face the Heat. Last night, they faced the heat of a Friday night game where, for the fifth straight time on a Friday night, the Celts went down to defeat, this time to San Antonio, 97-90. Larry Brown has his Spurs playing well. John Bagley was back, and Ed Pinckney was happy after the feed he gets here. These are the only 2 points Pinckney would score. Celts by three after the first quarter. The Spurs got it going in the second. Mo Cheeks on the run, and watch this feed from the left. David Robinson with authority. Spurs by four. It's all San Antonio in the second quarter. David Wingate off the steal, drops it off for Vernon Maxwell for the jam. Spurs on a 19-6 run to lead, 56-43 at halftime. Then Boston would close the gap. Dennis Johnson misses the jumper. Robert Parrish collects the rebound. He scores. Celts down by just three after three. But with John Bagley playing 18 minutes and the rest of the Celtics not able to keep up with the Spurs, it ends up being another fold for Boston on a Friday night, 97-90. The Spurs end up winning it. College basketball in progress at Northeastern. The UNH men's team losing to the Huskies. And New Hampshire College loses for the first time this season after 12 straight wins. The Penmen fall at Bridgeport by three. Other college basketball, top 10 action. Second-ranked Georgetown at DePaul. Late first half, score tied when Chucky Murphy drills a three-pointer to give the Demons a 35-32 halftime lead. The Hoyas will pour it on in the second. David Edwards takes it down low, and he'll leave his man in the dust. Look at this move. No problem. 7-point lead for Georgetown, 65-58. It'll be Alonzo Mourning leading the way for Georgetown. Keep your eye in the middle. Number 33 in the white jersey just muscles his way. I should say the dark jersey muscles his way for the rebound, puts it in. He scored 26. That's a 3-point play. The Hoyas take it by 10, 74-64. Top 10 scoreboard. Number 1, Kansas, a winner. Same for number 2, Georgetown. It's Michigan beating Minnesota. Oklahoma, no trouble with Texas. Missouri topples Nebraska. UNLV has to work hard to get past Temple. NC State falls at Georgia Tech, and it's Duke on top of Maryland by 11. The University of New Hampshire women's hoop team opened conference play with a win this afternoon. The Wildcats shut down Northeastern 61-51 in an ECAC North Atlantic Conference matchup carried live right here on WMUR. UNH head coach Kathy Sanborn knew her Wildcats would have to stop Talitha Cox, and Cox gets two off the feed from Charlene Blake, but Cox was held to just six first-half points. That's all she scored. She fouled out in the second half. A seesaw first half. Julie Donlin keeping the Cats close with one of her 3 three-pointers today. Donlin finished with 12 points. But once again, the big gun for UNH was Laura Seiden. Deb Dorsch fires cross-court to Seiden. She puts the move on Cox. 14 in the first half for Seiden. 29-28 UNH at halftime. Then the Cats open it up in the second half. Seiden in the paint pivots around, finally puts it up and hits 41-32 New Hampshire. Seiden finishing with 29 points. And shortly after, it's Donlin going to the trifecta again. Seiden clears it out. Donlin's wide open. Three more to make it 12-point cushion, 46-34. UNH goes on to win 61-51 to go 1-0 in conference play.
We got the